on here with a really slow flow mat Pilates. All you'll need is a ball and a towel, just if you want for modification. All right, let's hit the floor. So we are gonna start laying flat on our back. If you want, you feel free to come down Pilates style. So cut deep, the arms, cross the legs, come down bone by bone, super slow. Touching down. Once you get there, separate the feet, separate the arms. Maybe hold on to the first one, holding on to the back of the hamstring. Touching down, reach and lengthen, spine stretch. So from here, we're going to try to get as flat as possible. Pick up your entire mat here, reach and lengthen. So you have a super long, ears and lower biceps. Just kind of exaggerating, so we're going to reach off to one side and then a side body stretch. So we're trying to create that space between lats and your hips here. And then go ahead and take that same reach off to your side. So side body lateral stretch here. And then just kind of releasing that stretch. Arms are straight back behind you. And now from here, we're just gonna come to a couple small abdominal curls, getting warming up our core. Inhale back, exhale, abdominal curl, maybe lifting up one foot with the movement, super slow and steady. Inhale back, exhale, pull the abdominal in, lift that leg just about an inch or two off the floor. If you feel your low back, you're not gonna add on there. You're flexing out the foot. And then slowly peeling all the way back down. So from here, we're going to go ahead and bring our feet. Heels are together. Heels are in line with our sit bones. Press those shoulders down. Pull the abdominals in. Lift one leg up to tabletop. Lift the other leg up to tabletop. So from here, we're going to go ahead and press them down. Lift them right back up. Down an inch, up an inch. For three, two. Last one, soles of the feet come down, couple pelvic blocks. So just kind of shaking out, if that one felt kind of tight to you, we're just going to go ahead and shake out the tension. And now find your neutral here, so we're not arching, we're not tucking. So a little bit of that neutral where our hips are on the same plane here. And then from here, we're going to go ahead and lift those legs right back up. So legs come back up. Now we're pressing down one heel. Press down the other heel. If you're progressing, the gaze goes right to the leg. Elbows wide, chest is open. Pressing down one heel and the other. So our goal here is a slow flow. Try and go as slow as you can go. And then we'll go ahead and let that go. So soles of the feet come down. This time we're going to tilt the pelvis, heel up. Open up with a nice big bridge here at the top. And then coming all the way back down. Bone by bone, as slow as you can go. Once you touch down, you're going to tilt the pelvis again. So a little tuck of the tailbone and then start peeling all the way back up. Slowly come all the way back down one more time. This time, we're going to be doing some bridge work. So if you need a prop underneath, most advanced would be holding your bridge. But if you need a prop, a ball, or a rolled up towel will do the job. So you're going to go ahead and lift up the top. If you're using a ball, you're going to tuck the ball right underneath that stapler. And then just allow your weight to come down on the ball. If you're staying in bridge and supporting yourself, then you're just staying up there. If you're using the ball or the towel, just a slight lift. So you need a little bit of support underneath you. And now take, so we are in bridge. Take your right leg out. Press that leg out an inch and an inch. So small, try and keep the hips on the same plane. Try and keep the pelvis from moving here. Last three, last two, final one. Hold still. Tiny little circle. Go as slow as you can go. Switch that direction. And now hold right from here. You're going to turn out position. We're going to Pilates knee. Lift and lower. So this should fire up those inner thighs. And now keeping the other leg accountable, not letting the knee fan out to the side. Keep it in alignment. And now bring that foot down. Come down from the bridge so you get to release. Quick break. Take a nice big inhale through the nose, find space. Exhale, release, and use the tension. When you're ready, we're going to rise up to our lifted bridge. We want to lose support of the ball, so it's there for you if you need it. Lift the other leg. So now you're coming back into that abductor. You're going out and in and in. Out one and one, you're trying to keep the hips as quiet as possible as you age. And now hold still, tiny little circles. Pull the abdominals in. And now switch that direction. How slow can you go? Hold right there. You've got a turnout position in the Pilates V. You're up and in standing. So let's make the movement really small. Really trying to go slow and keep the pelvis quiet as I roll. And then slowly bring that foot back down. Go ahead and melt into the wall. So quick breather. Our next one, we're going to lift up to our hybrid jibbio ball, where we're removing that. And then we're hold up the top, press those knees towards each other, press them apart. For 4, 3, 2, last one. Separate the knees, come all the way down, bone by bone. Once you get there, arms out to the T, sway the knees from one side, looking in opposite direction. Use the abdominals to get them back into center. Same thing off the other side. We're going to add on here to pinwheels, so pinwheels, palms are stacked. Take a nice inhale and exhale. We're opening all the way up to shoulder height. If you can add on, you take that hand all the way back behind you. It's a nice big stretch. And then slowly bring it all the way back. The slower you go, the harder these are. So this is really a warm-up drill in that Pilates, a really beginner stretch. But when you notice going slow, you start really tapping into our powerhouse, moving that arm as the center of our body. So depending on your range of motion, any shoulder injuries, any rotator cuff injuries, you might not be able to bring that hand back. So when you're just stopping in alignment with your body, and then slowly bring it right back in. Bring it all the way back down. So you guys are just going to roll to the other direction. I'm going to just switch sides so that you can still follow me. So now the other hand is on top. You're in your side body tabletop. You have this mirror image of shoulders, wrists, elbows stacked. Take an inhale. On the exhale, we're gonna open up. Pull those abdominals in, so making sure you're moving from your center. Take that arm all the way back. So reach it back. Slowly bring it right back into center. Bring it all the way back down with that control. So pull the abdominals in. Take a nice big inhale here. On the exhale, you start opening up. Noticing the slower you go, the heavier that arm feels, the more connection you get with your center of your body. So slow flow isn't necessarily easy. It's just taking it down a notch, going slower, you're gonna actually pick up more resistance. Maybe find a connection that you've never found before. So that's our goal with Pilates, progressing every day, making it a little bit better. So slowly bringing it all the way back down. And then we'll go ahead and just press up on that palm, rise up to the top. We're going to go ahead, you guys can just stay right where we're at and rolling right to your backs. So we're coming into our Pilates 100 here. We're going to do a contemporary add-on to you. So feel free to stick with what you know, but I am going to be progressing this a lot. So lift up head, neck, and shoulders. Start pumping here. You're welcome to stay here the whole time. And as you notice, an inhale, 2, 3, 4, 5. Exhale, 2, 3, 4, 5. If you're adding on, lift one leg to take a pop. Inhale, 2, 3, 4, 5. Exhale, 2, 3, 4, 5. Bring that leg back down. Lift the other leg. Inhale, 2, 3, 4, 5. Exhale, 2, 3, 4, 5. Lift both legs up. Inhale, 2, 3, 4, 5. Exhale, 2, 3, 4, 5. Extension. Inhale, 2, 3, 4, 5. Exhale, 2, 3, 4, 5. Lift one leg up to tabletop. Inhale, 2, 3, 4, 5. Exhale, 2, 3, 4, 5. Bring that leg back down. Lift the other one. Inhale, 2, 3, 4, 5. Exhale, 2, 3, 4, 5. Bring that leg back down. Meet the rest of the head. And we power back up. Lift everything back up to tabletop. Inhale, 2, 3, 4, 5. Put the options in reverse. Exhale, 2, 3, 4, 5. Final set. Inhale, 2, 3, 4, 5. Exhale, 2, 3, 4, 5. Surrender, let it go. Rock from side to side. Shake that out, guys. From here, we're going to take it to a figure four. So just taking a nice stretch, but we're going to let the foot come down. We're taking a figure four with a bridge. Hands come to prayer behind the back. So you're opening up the chest. It's a balance challenge as well. Release the hands slowly. Come down as slow and controlled as possible from that bridge. Cross the other ankle over. Same thing. Slowly peel all the way back up. Lift up your bridge. Hands come to prayer behind your back. Open up the hip. Really should feel really great. And then slowly start to release those hands again. Come all the way back down, bone by bone. Slow, steady, control. Go ahead and hug those knees into the chest. Rock from side to side. Take down that tension. All right, guys, we're going to rock ourselves right up. Hold from here. Hold one ankle, hold the other. Hold your teaser. If you can add on, take those hands off and slowly tap the mat. Lift right back up. Tap the mat. Rest at these. Last five. Last four. Pull those abdominals in. 3, 2, how slow can you go? I'm shaking here. Go ahead and let those legs come down. You got spine stretch for those. Rise up to the top. Roll those shoulders back and down. We're going to do some of our series 5. It's more traditional, lay flat on your back. I know you all know it. We do it all the time, so if you need to, you're going to lay flat in your back. More advanced, we're doing it from up here today in our balance, like a teaser prep style position. So when you can, lift your legs up. So lifting your legs up, bring your hands behind the head. You got crisscross. Press out one leg and then the other. You got to push, you got to pull. Inhale. Exhale. Breathe through these. Inhale. Exhale. Keep your rotation really small so you don't rotate your back. Just firing up those obliques. If you need to, lay flat on your back. Keep your range of motion small. We're holding here. Shooting those abdominals. Slowly let those heels tap down. Lift them right back up. Pull those abdominals in. Touch down. Lift back up. Your legs, your limbs are your weight. Pull those abs in. Lift right back up. Final one here. You got these. And then go ahead and let those heels touch down. So we're in our forearm position, so we're active. We're not slumping. Just squeeze the knees from side to side here. Even, staying with you. Shake out any bit of tension. We're adding on. Lift the legs up to tabletop. You got your push. You got your pull. So our one leg stretch. Inhale, exhale. Push, pull. Make it a little slower. Make it feel a little harder. And now bring the legs straight up in the air. Feel the toes of the heart. You're lowering and lifting. Stay lifting that upper body. How slow can you go? 3, 2, last one. Soldier the feet come down. March it out. You're a little recovery before we come into our next one. March it out. You're still lifting the upper body. The upper body doesn't get a break. We're flowing. Keeping it fluid movement multiple times. Of course, if you need a break, take it. Slide that leg out. Slide it right back in. Slide the leg out. Slide it right back in. Inhale, lengthen and back. Tuck these abdominals, slide right back in. So if you're on carpet or something and it's not working, you're just letting that leg stay lifted, slowly bend. Last one here. And now we're lifting up. We've got scissor switch. Point your toes, hip length away. So we're not going to let the legs drop too low so we don't feel anything in the low back. Keep it more like a flutter up the top. Breathe through them for four, three, two, and go ahead and bend in those knees. Rock forward. You got your spine stretched forward. A little wonky on those. Okay, guys, we just got two more to go. So come back to those forearms. Heels are together, toes are apart. Push, pull. You got frog legs. Press in, press out. Press in, press out. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, exhale. Pressing in, pressing out. You got these. And now glue toes, glue heels together. You got a corkscrew in the tabletop. The further out those legs go, the harder this is. The slower you go, the harder it is. So inhale one circle. Exhale another. And then from here, over your head, spine stretch forward. Reach and lengthen. Get a nice big stretch. So from here, we're going to go ahead, sit tall. Arms are out. Come into your T position. Palms up. Press one up. If you're tight in your hip flexors, you're not going to compromise that spine. You're going to compromise by bending in the knees the way I am. So that you're in your nice tall spine. Remember, we're using no weights today. Our body is our weight. So go slower. Press those thumbs. Can you get them a little further back behind you so you start feeling those shoulder blades a little bit more? Up an inch, down an inch. Hold right here so you can go up all the way up to the shoulder height. Slow and steady. As you're moving, come all the way back down. Gaze out in front. Chin parallel to the floor. Crown of head reaching to the ceiling. How slow can you go? Pull those abs in. And now from here, turn those palms. Up and in, down and in. Up one, down one. Inhale, exhale. Press the pinkies back a little further. You have one long straight line. Breathe through them. Hold right here. Look over, right over the middle finger. Look to center. Look over the middle finger on the other side. Use your obliques to get back into center. Look over that middle finger. Come back into center. Look over the middle finger. Palms up. Legs straight. Spine stretched forward. Legs down. Bring your feet together. Quick weights. So rise up. Super tall. Ears and arms, biceps, pulling the abdominals in, let's reach the legs in over the knees. Slowly reach back your spine if you can, arms straight up over the head. You're folding out bone again. Slowly reach back that spine, grow tall. And now your hands back out. This time you bend in our knees. So bend in those knees, curl those hands in. Pull your hands into your shoulders. Reach and lengthen, right back out. So abs engaged. Take those arms in and out. Curl in, curl out. Try and gain your tall spine here. Collarbones are separated, shoulder blades are closer together. You're seated really tall here. Hold that square U. Bring your thumb and your pointer hands together. So almost like you're making a circle. Up and in, down and in. Keep those elbows in line with the shoulder. Up and in, down and in. Breathe through them. You got these. And now arms out long. Curl. Arms out long. You got to curl. Last one. and go ahead and bring it all the way in. So we're gonna sit crisscross, press down on those shoulders, take full advantage of the stretch, look over one shoulder, look over the other shoulder. Come back to center, switch arms, press down. And now look over the one shoulder. Come back to center, look over the other shoulder. Come back into center, press down one more time. And now from here, we're gonna go ahead and bring our soles to the feet here. We're gonna hinge back to that point where you already kind of can't shake it anymore, and then you're gonna curl those elbows in, reach the leg and come all the way back up. So rise back up, go all the way back up, over the long, slow as you can go. Once you get to that point, you're gonna curl. Open up, rise to the top. Go ahead and bring those elbows in closer, start coming down. Slow, controlled, breathe through them. Once you're at a point where it's really challenging, arms are long and straight. Reach back, inhale through the nose, and on the exhale, pull the abdominals in, rise up the same way. Once you can add on hands from behind the head, rise up. Elbows really wide here. And then go ahead and extend to the legs, spine stretch forward. From here, we're going to go ahead and come with our feet together. Toes, heels, knees, no legs to the legs. From here, hinge back to your best flat back. Open up to the knees. Bring it right back. Open up, so really rolling those palms, rolling those shoulders back, your best flat back, abs are engaged. Inhale through the nose, back up and out. And next one, hold it out there. Tiny isometric circles from here, pull those abdominals in, keep your knees and your obliques. Reverse. Breathe through them. Go ahead, bring those palms back together. Hold with the opposite hand to the side. You're going to go ahead, press in that hand. Press in for 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Switch hands, same thing on the other side. Press inward, fire up the obliques. How slow can you go? 6, 4, 5, 4, 3. Last one, both hands are off. You're coming down bone by bone. Low back, knees back, upper back, head, release. So taking a nice lengthening spine stretch. And then from here, we're going to rotate roll right to the side. So coming into a little bit of our side line. So from here, we're going to go ahead and keep the both legs up. One leg kick, one leg forward, one leg back. Inhale, exhale. Try and keep that bridge off the floor. Keep your head lifted. So breathe into these. Inhale, exhale. And now heels are together, toes are apart. Lift and lower from here. Pull the abdominals in. Heels together, toes apart. For 3, 2, last one, hold, toe to toe, top leg only circles, bottom leg covers, reverse that direction. And then go ahead and bend, bring everything back into center. We're going to go ahead, lift that top leg up, extension out in front. Bend, bring it right back in. Extension out in front. Slow and controlled. Bring it right back in. Should be cheeky here. Last one. And we'll go ahead and press ourselves up to center. So pressing up to center, we're going to go ahead and pull the hands right out in front. Hinge back to your best flat back. Pull the abdominals in, grow tall. hinge back, best flat back, rise all the way back up. Hinge back, rise back up. So the next one, you're gonna hinge back, open up that arm, come right back in. Hinge back, open up that arm, stretching, pull those abdominals in, hinging back. Pull the abdominals in, last one here, hinge back. And now from here, lift both legs up to tabletop. Hold on to one ankle, hold the other. Take that big stretch, and then slowly bend to the knee. Hold your ankle, slide the legs all the way out. Keep your quadriceps going. Restack your spine, and we're gonna go ahead and take this right off the other side. So we're sitting, we're laying on our side again. Head is down. And now from here, we're gonna go ahead and lift the legs up to a hover, just 1 inch forward, 1 inch back. So not like our leg pull or leg kick, we're gonna keep it a little smaller. If you can, lift your ribs off the floor, keep your head propped up. And now try and go even slower. Pull the abdominals in. And now slowly bring the feet down. Lift the heels and lower. So keeping the toes just a fist distance apart. So breathe through these. Last one. Hold the bottom leg up, parallel feet, circle just the top leg. Try to not roll that top hip forward or back. Reverse that circle. So breathing through these. Inhale through nose, exhale through mouth. And then from here, we're gonna go ahead and hold. Bring your legs in. So bring the legs into your tabletop. We're lifting that top leg up. We're kicking it out actually in front. So that's actually more advanced. If this is too much, don't add on with this one. Just lift in your tabletop. That'll be more modified. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale, use the abdominals to come back into that mirror image. Last two like this. Last one. And then we'll slowly bring that right back in. We're gonna go ahead and rise right back up to the top. From here, we're coming right to our knees into center. So we're gonna slide our hands all the way out. Take a puppy stretch where your forehead's down. Hips are up. If this is too intense, you're in a traditional shell stretch. Go ahead and bring those forearms down. So holding those forearms to the ground here. We're gonna go ahead and send the legs back. Come into a plank. Slowly come right back down to your plank. Roll up to your plank. Slowly come down, bone by bone, as slow as you can go. Hold that plank so your hips won't get as high if your elbows down this way. But try and go slow. Pull that stretch, come all the way back down. Knees come down, child's pose. Stretch it out. We're gonna slowly peel all the way up. Move your ankles, your toes, knees together here. We're gonna get our arms out to the side, so we're gonna really sandwich our ears with our biceps. Cross one thumb over the other, and then your pair of hands up at the top. Pull the abdominals in. You're going to press those hands way back. You're trying to roll down, and your goal is trying to get your forehead and your hands to come down at the same time, trying to not lead with the bipod. Hips are lifted off your heels, and then go ahead and slowly flatten out. That one's always a challenge, but we're going to try that one more time. So switch thumbs, the other one's on top now. Scoop in the belly, start rising up. The same way you can do that. You try as hard as you can to not lead with your body parts. So when you're ready, tuck that chin to the chest and start to come back down. So the idea is extension of the back, getting a nice flat back to those shoulder blades. So if you're trying to get them in your back pocket, try to not lean with your hands and your forehead. I know it's hard. Our first one is going to be a mini swan here. So that means our hands are going to be in alignment with our chest. Elbows close to your sides. Just lift up for a mini swan. And slowly come all the way back down. If you can add on to this, when we press up at the top, we're now going to take our hands off and try and come down that way. If you feel anything in your low back, don't lift that high. Take an inhale. On an exhale, we're pressing right back up to your head point. Take the hands off. Slowly come all the way back down. Our final one, keep it slow and steady. Press up into the hands. When you get to that point, towards your highest, hands come off, and try and lower down from there. Once you get down, you're going to take one cheek to the side, just shimmy your hips from side to side. Let that go. And now from here, arms are long and straight. Thumbs up completely, feet in parallel. We're going to go ahead and lift everything up. Press out, bring it right back in. Press out an inch, bring it in an inch. Out one, in one. For four, three, two, last one, bring it in. So we're going to add on. This time we're lifting up, keep one palm to the side, bring it right back in. Turn that palm, bring it right to your side. Of course, you might not have that mobility, bring the hands all the way, so it's really what works in your body. We got one more on each. If you need to, legs are down as well. Go ahead and release. Bring your hands back to where it was for swan. Press up. You got child's pose. So from here, we're going to try one more. We'll try a little bit of stretch. So grabbing onto one foot and then the other. If you can, you're going to open up the chest and just enjoy this nice big stretch. If this doesn't feel okay to you, you're just a child's pose. But if you can, take a nice inhale and exhale. Press up to that high point again. And go ahead and surrender. Let it go. Child's pose. We're going to go ahead and come into center mat so we can lift up towards up stretch, pressing down one heel and then the other. Pedal out through the feet. And then walk it into elephant to get a nice big stretch. Try to bring your chest as close to your thighs. Holding that stretch, just lift the heels. Press the heels right back down. Lift the heels to your round leg. Press those heels to elephant. And now chest lift to toes. Get a nice good stretch in the back side. Melt the toes back down. Soften the knees. And now we'll walk those hands back. Hold the stretch here. Sway from side to side. Hold back on. Shake the head, yes. Shake the head now. Hold, and then slowly lifting from your abdominal. Pull those abdominals in. We're rising all the way back up to the top. Roll the shoulders back and down here. And we're going to be standing at the back of our mat here. So we're going to be ready to come into some classical style push-ups. So arms come straight up. We're going to slowly come all the way down. So if you don't do these, push-ups to the wall will be a great modification. So coming all the way down, bone by bone, once you get here, you got four push-ups at the bottom. Maybe you're doing tiny isometric ones at the top, or maybe you're going for the full ones all the way down. When you get to that last one, soften up the knees, you're walking it all the way back. And then slowly peeling all the way back up. Arms come up, reach and lengthen. We're coming all the way back down. So this time, we're going to be adding on. When you come down, you're just holding plank. Hold your plank. Pull the abdominals in. You're going to cross to each opposite elbow. One more on each. And now pull forearms. Hold it up at the top. Hold here. Press the hip up for back in. You're in your forearms. Hold it here. Step out with one leg. Slow. Step out with the other leg. Control. How slow can you go? So rather you go slower than adding forearm. Last one on each. Go ahead and bring those knees down. Take a nice stretch. Child's pose, child stretch. Just kind of letting it go. From here, we're going to press up. Slowly walk it back. You rise all the way up. Roll the shoulders back and down. From here, we're coming into a little bit of our monkey squat. So, monkey squat, you press down and reach right back up. So, if you can, we're going to add on to these. We're going to try and get really low, reach and lengthen. So, if you want to take it like a stretch, you're going to go ahead and bend the knees, press those legs up. So, feel free, any of those versions I showed you. But otherwise, you're holding your toes and you're bending and extending the legs. So, you're getting a hamstring release here. But you're still getting back side of body work as well. You got these. For three, two, last one, pull all the way back up to the top. Roll the shoulders back and down. So from here, we're coming to a little bit of butt kicks. So if you can, you're gonna press your hands either up. You're just kind of alternating. You're bringing your heel to your seat. Keeping a soft knee. If you want, you're pressing back behind you to get the back side of your arms. Breathing through these. And now try and go really slow. Notice the difference. It's a lot more of a balance challenge here. So pressing back, pull the abdominals in, press back, heel to seat, any amount. Breathe through them, alternating from side to side, still staying upright in the end product. Final one. Shake that out. So quick shake. And now from here, our feet are in parallel. We're going to squat down, press one arm back, press the other arm back. And now press the elbows back. The next one, stay at your lowest point. You got side-to-side punches. So something we do with the springboard, press, reach, pull the abdominals in, cross body. You got these. Last one on each. And now you're gonna take it to that butterfly stretch. Reach your legs in, and then windmill to the other side. So another springboard exercise. Butterfly stretch, reach and lengthen, roll that shoulder back, taking that side stretch. And now hands come behind the back foot. You start folding forward, bring those arms straight up. Keep those, if you can, wrists start together here. Slowly rise up to the top. As slow as you can go, keep the hands glued here. Head is last to rise, release those arms. Bring them up to the top. Stack your palms, stack your feet, side bend. Just a little bit of a balance challenge with our legs close together. Pull the abdominals in, how slow can you do it? Bring it back to center. Bring it off to the other side. Keep your hips stacked. Hug your ears. Slowly use your abdominals to get back into center. And then from here, we're going to go ahead and come to the back of our mat. So stepping out with one leg, we're going to fold forward. Keep that front knee soft. Arms come back. Press up. Gaze is out in front. If this is too much, modified version right here. You're still in a balance challenge if you separate the legs that way. And then slowly bring it right back down. Bring that foot back. Step out with the other leg. Pull the abdominals in. Reach and lengthen. Same thing. Bring those hands, notice the difference from side to side. Bring those hands to their highest point. Press back. Last two. Last one. Step it back. Roll those shoulders back and down. Arms come up this time. Plug the shoulders down. Step out with one leg. Fold forward. And now, lift and lower, thumbs up to ceiling. For 4, 3, 2, last one, step it back. Arms stay straight, plug the shoulders down, step out with the other leg. Fold forward, thumbs up to ceiling. Square your hips, lower and lift. And now, step it back. Stay tall. Put your hands over your head. Hold here. Bring your arms down. You got a team. Press out one, up one. Out an inch, up an inch. Out one, up one. If you're adding on, lift your heels off the floor. You're blending the two exercises together. You're pressing back and you're lifting up. Raise your knees. Push the shoulders down away from the ears. Abs engaged. Maybe go even slower. And now heels come down, arms go back up. Step out. Arms out in front. Hold. Tap the mat with the back leg now. Lift right back up. 2 and 10. You're here. So feel free. You can keep it just 1 inch off the mat. For 3, 2. Last one. Arms up, step back. Very good. Arms in hard. Now you need to wait. Sign up. Step out. Pull it out. Arms falling straight. Tap and lift. Pull those abdominals in. Soft front knee. Last 3. Last 2. Final 1. Step it back. Go ahead and keep your side body stretched. One hand slides down the leg. The other arm goes straight over. Go ahead and keep that same stretch off the other side. So breathe it in. And now hands behind your back here. Just supporting, press those elbows back, look over, and now pull back down here. Slowly rising all the way back up. Hands come down by your side. And we're going to take your arms all the way back up here. So arms come straight back up to the ceiling here. Palms come behind, reach them like this. Elbows pulled in to the side of your head. You got prayer hands. Pull those abs in. Last 3. Last 2. Final 1. Hands come to the hips. Lift the leg up to tabletop. Pull the abdominals in. Bend. Extend. Bend. Extend. 5. 4, 3, 2, last one, cross over, lift, cross, take that foot to the outside, lift, for 4, tap it with just the toes, 3, 2, last one, hold, take that ankle over. Prayer hands in front of the chest. We have a balance to your core. Let that leg go back behind you to launch that stretch. Back heels down. Come back into center. So same thing on the other side. Hands come back to the hips. Lift the leg up to tabletop. Pull the shoulders back and down. Bend. Extend. Bend. Extend. Breathe through them. Last 2 like this. How slow can you go? And now from here, we cross. We lift. Cross. So I just want in the back of your head. Doesn't have to be so slow. You want fluid in Pilates, but just try to go a little bit slower than you're used to. So that you pick up that automatic resistance and tell them challenge the body a little bit more, maybe feel a little more connected. And now from here, cross that ankle over. You have a balanced finger four. Flex out on that foot if it's available. Keep your hands, thumbs at heart center. Slowly release. Come back into center. Arms come up. We have a final roll down here today. So slowly come down, bone by bone, as slowly as we can do. Just sway those hips from side to side. Take out any last attention. And then slowly restack your spine. If you want to add a little bit more challenge, bring your hands behind your head. Push your head. Give me a downward. Roll the shoulders back and down. And we are done, guys. Awesome job. Thanks for joining me today.